Here it is. It's the teardrop. Donated to the cause by one of my viewers. We'll just call him Sean Smith. But we're out here north of Hollywood somewhere. We got all the pieces. And we're about to head out. This thing will get put back together and restored and working, and probably only take 2 years. Well, you've seen all this before. This is for the Shasta. We got some weather coming, and I want to get some of the brows on, so we're going to polish those up today. And we got a lot of other things coming up for the near future here. Going to do a video on basic towing safety. Everything involved with towing. We're going to do one of those. Backing into a spot without hurting your trailer or other people and the trees. How to set your trailer up, how to hook it up properly, what weights you should tow with what vehicle, all that kind of stuff. Sometimes the traffic makes it hard to do a video around here. So anyway, just wanted to let you know that we got some other things coming up here in the near future. And I want to give a shout out to Sean, thank him for the teardrop that I picked up over the weekend. I rescued that. It was headed for the scrap pile, and he was kind enough to contact me and ask me if I might want to take on the project. He was about midway through reframing and everything, and kind of gave up on it for other reasons. He had other projects to do, and asked me if I wanted to complete it, and I said, of course. So we're going to get working on that here, probably not for another month or two, but we'll get to it. That'll be a lot of fun. And of course, I want to get this Shasta finished up and get it back up to its owner, and get some work done on the Ken skill. So that's where we are right now, folks. There's a difference. There she is. It's one baggage door ready to go on. Oops, got a little. Yeah, you want to clean these off with Windex. Of course. They'll get even brighter and shinier because some of the pits will hold the rouge, and you can clean that out. So there you go. I've got the Westerner back here at my place. I'm gonna finish up the ceiling. I took all the screws out of the windows and took all the brows off and everything because it was going to get painted, and then it sat there forever and it still hadn't gotten painted. They sanded it, but we have weather coming and it's been sitting outside, so he's going to have to paint it with the windows in it because I don't want any more damage to happen to the paneling inside of this one. But anyway, I wanted to show you a trick. When it's warm outside, you know, I'm not hot, but when it's warm, you know, when it's nice and you have the sun on your working surface, that's when you want to put the window in. That way the putty tape is soft enough that it seats, the window will seat, whatever you're putting in will seat and squish the putty tape out, okay? If it's cold and hard in the morning, then it won't do that and it won't seal as well. So when it's nice and warm outside, like it is today here, it's probably, 70? Yeah, it's probably 70. I hear everybody in the East Coast and Midwest is just freezing to death, but here it's nice. So this is what you want your putty tape to look like when you're finished. But don't take it off in the heat because it wants to stick to where it is and it makes it difficult. So I'll show you that, which I think I've showed you before, but I'll show it to you again tomorrow morning when it's cooler. And that way when you take it off with the razor knife, it just falls off. So just a little hint there. Yeah, I have to get this thing sealed up. It's mostly all sealed. I've already did all the J-rail and a lot of other things to it. So now I'm just sealing up the windows. And I'll probably bag it up anyway because there's no longer any seal. The lights are, the light holes are exposed and stuff. He had those off. I had to put them back on so I could transport it over here. And I have to redo this whole door thing here. So, working on everything at once. And we're going to put a brow on. Be on the street side of the baggage door. I'm going to clean it first with a little Windex. It's easier before you get the screws in it. Shouldn't leave a lot of residue on this time. Weather coming. Now what I usually do, do two at a time, and you can split this stuff in half. Save a little money. You get yourself a length there. Cut this right down the middle. Probably easier with a razor knife. Probably take less time. I think I'll try that. I don't really know if this will work well or not. I haven't tried it. Yeah, that works. Thank you. about that? Piece over here, this piece, and we're going to put it all on top edge so it covers up the screws. You want to make it go right to the edge of the metal. Okay? Right to the edge of the metal. That's, and the excess will come squeegeeing out. You want to cover the holes. You always want to cover the holes where the screws, no matter what you have to do, even if you have to add more little round things or something like that. You always want to make sure you cover the screw holes so that the screw has to go through this stuff in order to put the screw in. And it's because you want everything gooped up. Every place water can get, you want it to get gooped up. I need it a little bit longer here. The other one comes through the down part. Same thing will happen on the other one, so the next one, so I'll just save this piece, the extra piece. Paper off, leave the putty tape on there, do the same thing, pull it straight back so that it doesn't pull the putty tape off your work. If you lift up on that even a little bit, it'll pull the putty tape off there. Okay, here we go. Just stick it on there. Yeah, this one did come off. I think, well, no, I'm not sure. But, all the other brows on this trailer, yeah, this is not the one that came off here, but the holes seem to match up. I guess they're all the same. Maybe. They're close. Very close. So, you kind of want to look at where you're going with it. And start a screw, just like all the other, like the windows and everything. And then before you go too crazy, you want to make sure everything's lined up and that the door works. There we go. It's level. You don't want to push too hard yet. You want to make sure you're covering everything up. Alright, so you made sure that everything's straight, and you want to make sure that the door will pass by there without hitting it. Okay, so we're covering everything. Everything's straight. We can go ahead and screw this screw in. Okay. Let's double check again. Make sure it passes by. Okay, plenty of clearance. Okay, good. Don't go too tight on these. I mean, you want them leak-proof, but you don't need to suck the world in there. Sideways on you, there's not a lot you can do about it. But it's on the street side, so the ugly side. Oops. Where that screw came from, but it doesn't fit. Again. Put the lock set in it. It's one of these. These are all key to life. And that's going to have to be another project because, here, see how that works? Because I have to mortise this out here for the lock set. You're probably asking yourself why I didn't do that before I installed the door. Well, I had a reason. But I don't remember what it was. Anyway, so yeah, I've got to do that. That'll be easy enough to do here. Not a problem, really. Got to get the Dremel to do that. Before I do, I'm going to put the other brow on the other side. Enough over here where it's cool enough, I can go ahead and trim this. It just kind of falls off. Be careful and not go too far here. Scratch the paint. There we go, got the brows on the backside windows and the back, the rear storage compartments, both sides. So, got that done today. Let me get around all my junk here. Got a little piece of cardboard holding that closed because the rain's coming. The other one stays closed by itself. And yeah, so there we go.